Hello, my name is Salvatore Lombardo. I work as a postdoc at IRAE, and here I will shortly present my project, Molecular Machines Based on Nanocellulose. Molecular machines can be defined as molecular components with specific properties, able to respond to external stimuli. Three researchers were awarded with the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 2016 for their work on molecular machines. The group of Jean-Pierre Sauvage was able to synthesize molecular chains. The molecule shown in the picture is able to rearrange when an electrochemical potential is applied. The group of Stoddart presented more elaborated molecular systems. Here I give the example of a molecular shuttle. It is based on ring-like molecules called rotaxanes, which are able to act as a bead trapped on a linear thread, terminated by bulky stopper groups. The position of this molecular bead can be switched selectively by applying external stimuli, for example, protonation. The group of Feringa presented even more elaborated systems called molecular motors. If the molecule is indicated as number one, it is irradiated with UV light at 60 degrees, four consecutive isomerization reactions will occur, leading to a complete rotation of the molecule. These molecules are able to convert energy into rotary motion, behaving like molecular wheels. It is interesting to mention that the process of light-induced isomerization employed here is also used in nature in the process of vision. We can say that, despite the system presented are based on synthetic chemistry, nature has been the main source of inspiration. Biological molecular machines are very common in nature and form the basis of life. Cells can be considered as molecular factories, as they contain many molecular machines. For example, proteins, which can adapt their shape to perform a specific function. The example here shows a protein machine responsible for DNA replication. More sophisticated biomolecular machines are ribosomes, which are able to translate proteins. Our research focuses on studying the properties of the cell wall, which is present in plant cells. Plant cell wall can also be taken as a molecular machine, if we consider it as an adaptable container with specific permeability and mechanical properties. In nature, cellulose and xyloglucan form the plant cell wall together with other biopolymers. Cellulose is a polymer made up by linear chains of sugar molecules and responsible of the mechanical properties of the cell wall. Xyloglucan is also a polymer, which is known to interact with cellulose in the cell wall. Inspired by plant cell wall, we decided to use the cellulose-xyloglucan interaction to prepare bio-inspired microcapsules. Such structures are made by only natural compounds and may replace synthetic material in various applications. Our strategy consists in using a hard template of calcium carbonate microcapsules and to attach nanocellulose and other polysaccharides in a layer-by-layer approach, followed by dissolution of the template. Our aim is to have a better understanding of the interactions which stabilize the plant cell wall and to use these interactions to form microcapsules with specific properties, which can be directed by external stimuli. If you remember, this is the definition of a molecular machine. The template used consisted of microcapsules of calcium carbonate. The other components were cellulose nanocrystals, which were negatively charged, and xyloglucan, which was marked with a fluorophore and is shown in red in the picture. The red color of the particle's wall indicates a successful attachment of xyloglucan. Normally, 5B layers or less were prepared, as more layers would increase aggregation between particles. By dissolving the core in diluted hydrochloric acid, the calcium carbonate template is removed and hollow capsules are formed. Here, another example of the core removal process. A comparison between a microscopy image recorded under visible light on the left and under fluorescence light on the right indicates that the layer-by-layer assembly works very well. However, we have issues with stability after core removal. See pictures on the bottom. One problem is that wall thickness is very small, and so the particles are not easy to observe under visible light. The second problem is that the particles aggregate. Improvement must be made to increase the stability of the capsules. An idea is to prepare microcapsules with a thicker wall, for example by adding a filler material. Another idea is to use stronger interactions between components, for example with covalent bonds. Once stable microcapsules are prepared, we will study the properties of this material, for example the change of permeability as function of pH, as shown in the picture, or as function of water stimuli, for example ionic strain. We will then use these properties to encapsulate active compounds. This will allow us to prepare stimuli-responsive bio-inspired molecular machines that can be used as drug delivery carrier or as adsorbent for water cleaning and other applications. I would like to thank Anna Villars and Bernard Català for their help and supervision. I would like to thank also Bruno Novales for his help with confocal microscopy, and I would like to thank Magali Weber, Céline Moreau and Nadège Larrey for revising this video, and all people of our research group.